Hey, welcome to Dad Can Cook. And this is a little special episode that I'm making here. You know, the holidays are coming. And I'm going to put together a couple of things that are good to put out or to make for your holiday, you know. Like, we're going to make a cream of asparagus soup with Parmesan cheese and garlic. It's absolutely delicious, okay? And I'm going to show you how to make this pretty much step by step, okay? And then we're going to make a cranberry, pineapple, and mandarin orange chutney to go on the bottom of a breaded pan-fried brie, okay, that you can put out as an appetizer or for snacks for people to put on their crackers and toast points and stuff. So we're going to do that, and I'm going to show you the soup first. So let's get, come over here, let me show you. Okay, now I don't know if you saw the other day, but I posted I got some asparagus for real cheap, okay? And what I did was is I cut it up. Let me show you how I cut it, okay? I cut them and I put them in water so they would rehydrate. But now what you do is you want to make sure you're not going to get any woody parts in your soup. So we took off 2 inches, and I'm probably going to take off another inch and a half or so right here. Right, this is going to go in the garbage, and then these are going to be chopped up in the small pieces so they cook fast and I can blend them easy, okay? And I'm going to put them in with my other asparagus here. Now what I have in these asparagus, I have 3 heads each in these containers with 1 medium onion diced in each one, okay? On my stove, right over there, I have 1 gallon of chicken stock, okay? And then over here, I have asparagus that I'm gonna steam and use these as a garnish on top when I plate it, when I serve it. So I'm gonna put these off to the side. Okay, I'm going to grab my coffee because it's 10 o'clock in the morning and I'm prepping all this up. Excuse me. Okay, so now I have my asparagus. Okay, I have 1/3 cup of grated Parmesan cheese. I have 8 cloves of roasted garlic. The roasted garlic, what I did was is I put a little olive oil on a sizzle platter, 8 cloves of garlic, put it in the oven, roasted them, smashed them, and chopped them. And that's that right there, okay? And then I have 2 cups of heavy cream. Now first, what we're gonna do is we're gonna saute the onion. Come on over here. We're gonna saute the onion and the asparagus and the garlic in these pans here, and then I'm gonna put it in the pot. Okay, so let me turn these on to get hot. Okay, and as soon as they're hot, we're gonna get busy. In each pan, I'm gonna put 1/2 stick of butter in each one. And then I'm gonna take my extra virgin olive oil, put in like 2 tablespoons in each one of those. Okay, we're gonna get that hot. Okay, it's starting to get the temperature. Let's get this, got this pot, and I got this pot right, pan right here, right? Okay, so now we're gonna take the garlic. I'm gonna put 1/2 of it in this one, 1/2 of this one, it doesn't matter because it's all going in the same place at the end. Right? We're gonna mix that around. I don't wanna burn it. Then I'm gonna put this one on here, this one on here, and we're gonna mix them around. We're gonna give them a light saute. Okay, we want to sweat it out a little bit. Gonna mix that garlic up in there with that. Whoops. Okay. And we're gonna let this go for a couple minutes, and then we're gonna dump it in the pot. Now, if this is too much for you, you cut the recipe in half. This is 6 pounds, was 6 pounds to start with. That's with the stems. So it's probably about 4.5 to 3 pounds worth of asparagus. I mean, four and a half to 4 pounds worth of asparagus there after the ends are chopped off. Okay, let me just wipe my hands here. Okay. So, this is coming out nicely. Smell it, it smells delicious. I love asparagus. Makes your pee stink. Okay, almost ready. Beautiful. The onions are getting soft. Yep. That's what we want. Okay. Now this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna take this and we're gonna put it right there. And I'm gonna dump these in. Everything. Okay, put that in the sink. Next, dump that one in. Put that in the sink. Now, we're gonna let that cook. This is a fast soup. We're gonna let this cook. This is gonna go for about 10 minutes, okay? Right now, I'm gonna slowly pour in my cream and whisk it in, okay? Okay, we're gonna let all those flavors incorporate. Then, when it's in 10 minutes, I'm gonna move it over there. We're gonna put the emulsifying blender in it. I'm gonna puree it all up. And then I'm gonna thicken it with a little bit of roux. Now, I've made the roux 100 times, so you can go to any one of my videos and see how I make the roux. But it's equal parts of flour and butter melted in a pan. And then you take pieces of, you make it like a nice blonde color. And then I put it in the refrigerator, in a container, and I use it as I need it. And I'll show you that when we're gonna do it. I have some in the fridge. And we're gonna thicken that up just a little bit, okay? So as soon as that's ready, we're gonna come back and look at that. Me, the grill man. And I just wanna say, hey, while we're waiting for that soup to come to a boil and the stuff to get tender so I could emulsify it, I wanna show you. This is a KitchenAid emulsifying blender. Okay, in the restaurants we have big ones. You know, you can literally probably put it on the back of a canoe and use it as a motorboat, as a motor. But this here is the best investment you could buy. This is a great gift for the holiday, okay? This one is a KitchenAid. It's a little more expensive. It has speeds. But you could buy one for like $19 in the store. And it doesn't have speeds, but it's good. And it's a great, great gift. The piece comes off here, right? And you can put a piece on that has a whip like this. And I don't know where it is right now. I'm not gonna go look for it. But this is a great gift, okay? I just wanted to, if you don't have one, get one. You can do stuff right in your pot. Okay, it's coming to a boil now, right? Now we're gonna let this go for about 5 minutes at a hard boil. I'm gonna turn it down for a simmer for about 2 minutes, and then we're gonna hit it with the emulsifier, and we'll be back and I'll show you that. Okay, so I just turned it back up. Okay, the stuff's nice and soft in there. My asparagus are nice and soft in there. Okay, we got the garlic, the roasted garlic in it. It's gonna give it a little subtle taste. Not too much, but it's nice little subtle taste to add to the asparagus, right? And then we're gonna hit it with the Parmesan cheese. And I'll show you that right now as we're gonna go over and emulsify it. So we're gonna come over here. Okay, I'm gonna put this right here. Turn the oven off. I got my emulsifier plugged in. Here we go. Let me see that. Let's get it so you can see this. Now this sucks it all in, like a whirlpool. Now I had that on the stove for about 8 minutes, right? Once you get your prep done, this soup takes like less than 20 minutes to make. Turning a nice shade of green for the bisque, like what you want to see. Now you lift this up and go down. You go up too much, you're gonna splatter it, so you don't wanna do that. And that's boiling stuff, so you don't want that splattering in your face. Okay, beautiful stuff. Now, I got my third of a cup of Parm. Now, that's pretty much pureed. Now, let me get a spoon to taste it. A couple of spoons here. Let me taste this here. Oh, my God. My God, that is so delicious. That is delicious, okay? But it's too thin. I got to thicken it up a little bit. So we're going to go back to the fire, okay? I'm gonna bring this back there. Let me give it another second on this here. Look how smooth that is. This machine works great. Chopped all that stuff up in no time. Made no work of that at all. Okay. Then the piece comes off right in the sink. Clean it right up. Okay, now let's go back over here. Okay, put this back on the fire, turn it back on high. Okay, and then here's my roux. Okay, flour and butter. Okay, I make one up. I make usually make a pound of each, put them in the fridge, and it'll get me through the holidays of thickening stuff. I have an episode on this. You can check it out. If you can't find it, let me know. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to get this back up to temperature, because this has to kind of be simmering boil for this to work. Okay. Now I softened this in the microwave. It comes out hard as a rock, but I softened it for 30, 40 seconds in the microwave to make it soft so I could do this. Right, I can take it and I'm gonna put it right into the pan. As soon as that comes up, right into the pan, pot, and whisk it right in. Okay, here it comes, see it? Starting to go. Okay. Starting to bubble up. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with this. And I'm gonna whisk it in. make sure. Now I don't want to make this too thick, because otherwise I'm going to have to thin it out then with chicken stock and or heavy cream. I want to make this a beautiful, beautiful thick, but not over thick and overbearing soup. Okay? So you got to give it a minute to let that roux work. Needs a little more. Now you add it a little at a time, because you can't take it away. You can always put more in, but you can't take it away. Now, I want to get a spoon. I want to show you the thickness. Turn that down a bit. It's looking good. Okay. That's still, see that? That's still a little too thin for me. So, one more little bit should do it. I gotta make more roux. That should do it. Now, if you make this, and like I said, you know, use a half recipe as much as you want, how you can make it. You saw what I did. Cut that in half, you can cut that in quarters. Okay, but if you make it and it's too thick, especially after it cools down, you can add chicken stock and or heavy cream or a combination of both, one or the other. Okay, basically, this soup is done. Now what I'm going to do with this when I serve it, and I'll show you when I'm going to serve it, is I'm going to grate. I'm going to put a floater of heavy cream on the bowl. I'm going to put the 3 pieces of asparagus in it, and then I'm going to grate some slivers of Parmesan cheese on top. And that's all she wrote on that. Now, that's not being served till tonight. But now we're also going to go to the chutney recipe, all right? And then I'll show you that. And at the end of it all, I'll put it all together and show you everything. I also just wanted to tell you, add salt and white pepper to taste as how you like it or how you want to serve it to your guests, okay? Okay, here's the plating of the soup. Here we go, let's see. Got that there? Okay. Now I got my soup right here. Okay. This is going to be like part of the main meal, so we're getting a full bowl. Like so. Okay. Then I'm going to take a spoon of heavy cream, sour cream. I'm going to put that there. I'm going to put the crouton like that. I'm going to put my asparagus. Like so, and then a sprinkle of aged Parmesan that I grated. So there you go. What do you think of that? Beautiful, huh? Okay, stay tuned for part two. Okay, motoring along in this part two of this video, we're going to make this chutney, this cranberry pineapple mandarin orange chutney, and it's going to be so good, and it's going to be so delicious to go with that brie, that pan-fried brie that we're going to bread after we make this chutney. Okay, so let me show you what we got. Okay, now remember, you can cut down these recipes. You don't have to make as much as I do, but this also goes great with Virginia ham and ham products, and turkey, everything. This is so good. Okay, so what we're gonna start with is 3 cups of fresh cranberries. I got a cup and a half of fresh cut pineapple. You could use canned pineapple if you want, but this is fresh cut pineapple. This is a 15 ounce can of mandarin orange with the juice. We're gonna use that juice. That's a half of a yellow pepper and a half of a red pepper diced. That's a half of a red onion diced, medium to large red onion diced. Not one of those jumbo ones, okay? I got a half a cup of brown sugar, 2 tablespoons of honey, and a third of a cup of apple cider vinegar, okay? Now we're gonna come over here. All right, so we're gonna get the pan going. Put it on high. Okay, that pan's getting hot, right? We're gonna take our cranberries. We're gonna put that in. We're gonna take our pineapple, our peppers. We're gonna get those in. The red onion. We're gonna get that in. Okay. We're gonna take the juice of the mandarin oranges and we're gonna put that in. We're gonna save these till the end. The brown sugar. The vinegar. This is so easy. And the honey. Okay, we're gonna mix it all up. And we're gonna let that come to a boil where these start to break open. Okay, now these are gonna go for probably 5 to 7 minutes before they start to really percolate in there. So we'll be back when that happens. Okay, that's about 4 minutes right now and it's starting to bubble up. So we're gonna add the pineapple. And the mandarin orange. Okay. Now we're gonna let that go until all of the cranberries burst open. Probably gonna be about 5 minutes. Okay, we're gonna take it the rest of the way on tape. Okay, we can watch them break open. They'll start to bust open any minute now. They're starting already. I don't know if you can see them. You can help them along a little bit. I'm moving them around. Ooh, they're nice and soft. Okay, we're breaking them all up. Getting that all nice in there. Look at that. Yeah, look at that. Okay, now we're gonna let this reduce down, drain out some of that liquid for a minute or two, okay? It's been going for about 4 minutes. It's almost done. We're gonna tighten it up now, and I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do. Over here, I got some cornstarch and a bowl. All right, I'm gonna take a, wow, about that much cornstarch, okay, on a tablespoon. I'm gonna put it in there. I got hot water running here. A little bit of hot water. I'm gonna mix it up to dissolve it. Back over here. I hate this camera. My other one's broken. Okay, look at that. It's starting to thicken up. Now, we're not going to use all of this. It's starting to thicken. We're just going to use a little bit to help the thickening along. To kind of make it like jelly. Look at that. Just a little bit more. Look at that. Nice. Now when this cools down, it's gonna get harder. Okay, that's basically done. Now that's done, I'm gonna take that off to cool it to the side, and then when I come back, I'm gonna bread the brie, okay? And get that all set up. And I'll show you that when I come back. Okay, I'm back. We're back with Dad Can Cook. Okay? And now for this other part of this awesome, awesome episode, we're gonna bread the brie. Okay? Okay, and let me show you what we're gonna do. Okay. Come over here. I got this wheel of brie here, right? And I cut it into pieces already. I cut it into, let me get my knife. I cut it into wedges, like so. Okay. And I measured them out to try to get them as even as possible. And what I'm gonna do with those is I'm gonna bread them. I'm gonna flour, egg, and breadcrumb. Let me get that all on there. Okay, I got the flour, egg, and breadcrumb. So we're gonna start with flour. Get them all floured nicely. Then really egg them up. And we're gonna double bread these. Because we're going to saute them and bake them, okay? So we're going to get breadcrumb all over these. Especially on the cheesy part there, see? We got that. Now we're going to put it back in the egg. Okay, and we're going to bread it again. Give it a double breading. See that? Okay, we're going to do that with all of these pieces. Okay, in the egg. Get it all egged up. And now I have four eggs and a little milk. Okay. Bread these up. Okay. Egg again. Back in the breadcrumb. Okay. It's two. I'll show you one more. Flour it all up. Egg it all up. Get that egg all over it. In the breadcrumb. Okay, this is Progresso Italian style breadcrumb. Okay, back in the egg. Back in the breadcrumb. Get that all coated so it doesn't ooze out when we saute it and put it in the oven. Okay, so that's three pieces. I'm going to finish these up, and when I come back, We're going to saute them, and then we'll put that plate together for you, okay? And then I'll show you everything when I'm going, when it's going out,
hey,
when the people come
doing?
In. Okay, we're back now, and we're going to saute that up. Okay, my company's coming over in 10 minutes, and let me show you. I got the plates all set up for the brie, okay? I got my garnish all set up for the soup. I'm ready to go, okay? Everything's gonna be easy breezy, lemon squeezy for me, okay? So I'm gonna saute this up. When they come over, I'm gonna put it in the toaster oven and bake it for just about 5 minutes to get it soft in the center, and then I'm gonna serve it that way. And I'll show you when I serve it. But come on over here. I got my pan here, getting hot. Here's my soup, right, that we made earlier. And here's my pan with my combination of olive oil and vegetable oil, okay? We're gonna get that hot, and as soon as that's hot, we're gonna start making
hot enough,
and we're gonna get them going now, and we're gonna brown these bad boys. Okay. I'm gonna do four and then two, because I don't wanna overcrowd the pan, because I need to turn them and stuff, you know what I'm saying? So we're gonna get them going. Now I don't wanna cook these all the way through, I just wanna brown the breadcrumb on it and then finish baking it in the oven. Okay, that's the procedure of what we're gonna do. I'm afraid I'm going to run out of my battery. Here. That's not on. Okay. Okay. We got that going. Nice. There we go. That's what we're looking for, right? See that? That's what we're looking for.
I'll probably shower. I have to go to the mall. I'll go to the mall Saturday morning.
Okay. Rounding them up. Whoa. A little splatter there. Get my rag. Okay, our guests are gonna be here any minute, and then I'll be done. Everything's gonna be easy peasy. Okay, that's looking good. So now we're gonna go that way. I'm gonna go that way. I'm gonna go like that. While that's doing it, well, I'm gonna put these in here. The brown. Then once that browns like that, we'll go to the other side. Go to the other side. See that? Okay. That oil is getting nice and hot. So we're going to put them there like this. Whoops. See, nice and brown. Oh, you see that? Back that out. I didn't realize it was that close. Okay. Okay. Okay, now I'm going to turn this on. Get that preheated. Okay. sideways. See that? Okay. Turn that off, get that off the fire. Now I have these here, right? And right before we're gonna eat, I'm gonna put them in the oven for about 5 minutes to heat them up and make them a little bit soft. And when I do that, we'll be back, okay? Okay, so now I'm gonna put the brie in the toaster oven here that I have, right? And we're gonna heat it up. So, this is going in, and it's gonna go in there for about 5 minutes, and then I'll show you the plating. Okay, I just took it out of the toaster oven. Here they are, okay? And I'm gonna take this one, I'm gonna put it on the plate, and this is the one I'm gonna show you, because we're getting ready to eat, and I don't have time to do them all. But there it is, okay? Cranberry pineapple chutney with mandarin orange, garlic toast points, and sauteed pan and fried brie.
Two Triscuits.
Okay, and we'll be back for the soup. Okay, now we're coming down to the wire here. The soup's heated up. We're gonna serve the soup. I'm gonna show you how that looks, and then we're gonna be done, okay? Here we go. Soup's on the fire, right there. I'm gonna bring it over here. Here it comes. Oh, now this soup, you really don't want to. This is a great soup because in the summer you could chill it and serve it cold, and you could serve it as hot as you want, and this is just hotter than warm. It's hot, but it's not boiling hot. Okay, so here we go. There we go. Okay.
The first time he yelled, and I don't know how long we were together when he did that. Boy, I mean, Sam just jumped off the floor because she'd never heard him yell before. I forget. And all you did was yell my name or something. I mean, it's not like you could yell me. You just yelled.
Okay, look at this. Beautiful, right? Okay, now I'm gonna take a paper towel. Okay? Right? Now, I pre-made the garnishes so I could just drop them on. Look at that. Beautiful, right? Okay, and then at the table, I put shredded Parmesan cheese on. I grated it for them right at the table like this. I have it grated here, but I put it on just like that. Okay? I'm glad you enjoyed the video. Some call me Nicky and some call me Roman. Caesar, please, I'm in a visa. Just a visa, not eat my own sneaker. Sexy, sexy, that's all I do. If you need a bad bitch, let me call up yo. Come soon and I'm living many services out. I see some good girls, I'ma turn them out. Okay, bottle, sip, bottle, guzzle. I'm a bad bitch, no muzzle. Hey? Bottle, sip, bottle, guzzle. I'm a bad bitch, no muzzle. Music makes me.